So calculating the chi-square test shows us that these two risks, not only are they different, but they differ significantly. The p-value is around 4%, so it's not a very strong rejection of the null hypothesis, but the fact remains that not only is the risk not the same, the risk of dying is significantly higher if you do not get the BCG vaccination. How can we quantify how much higher it is? Well, there are two ways we'll discuss right now, because they are easy, and then there's another way, that's the odds ratio, that's a bit more complicated, that we'll save for later. So I can take the two risks, I can subtract them, and I can say that the risk is 1.16 percentage points larger if you do not get the vaccination. I can also form the ratio, getting 1.31, so the conclusion then is that the risk is 31% larger if you do not get the vaccination. And notice that this is exactly the same result. There's no wrong or right. Everything here is correct, but how you communicate it is of course important. A risk difference of 1.1 percentage point may appear to be small to some people, and a relative risk of 31% may appear to be large to some people, but it is exactly the same difference. So if I want to calculate the risk difference, I use the risk diff option. It happens like this, and here I can use the trace on option to see the names of all the different parts of the output, and I can see that I have to write ODS select column 1 risk estimates. Why column 1? Well, if you go up and look at the table again, here is column 1, that's the dead children, so this is the risk we're interested in. You can also calculate the risk or probability of surviving. This is not our focus here, our focus is on the risk, so this is why we write column 1. And if you specify column 1 risk estimates like this, this is the table you get out of SAS, and here is the difference of 1.16 percentage points, and you can see that it's specified here, the difference is row 1 minus row 2. So it's not very difficult to change the minus to a plus and say that you have the same result. If we want to do it in SAS, SAS always gives us row 1 minus row 2, so if we really want the 0.0116 without the minus sign in our SAS output, we have to fix it by reverse scoring. So here I code it in another way, so now I switch around the two rows. When I switch around the two rows and still look at the column 1 risk estimates, I get the same thing, and now the difference is 0.0116. I can add an option saying exact risk diff that gives me exact confidence limits for the risk difference. We don't discuss this in this call, but you can see that something is missing over here, and we can add it using the statement exact risk diff. So instead of calculating the absolute risk, you might instead be interested in the relative risk. And to talk about the relative risk, we can talk about the risk ratio. I calculate the risk in one group, I calculate the risk in the other group, and I form the ratio. And the null hypothesis is just this RR equal to 0. That's the null hypothesis. We can also define the odds. So instead of looking at the risk of dying in the exposed group, I can look at the odds of dying in the exposed group. And you'll notice that this is simpler to calculate. We don't need the total, we just need the numbers A and B. You can also notice that the risk and the odds contain exactly the same information. So if I know the risk, I can calculate the odds. If I know the odds, I can calculate the risk. There's no new or other information. I can also see from this that if I have a situation where something makes the risk higher, then the odds are higher. So if I find out that exposure increase the odds, then I know that that exposure increases the risk. So the odds ratio is simple to compute because you only use the four numbers in the table, and we can test the null hypothesis that the odds ratio is equal to zero. Now in the 2x2 table, I can take the numbers and just go up and look at the 2x2 table up here. I can take these four numbers and I can calculate the odds in group 1. I can calculate the odds in group 2. We can see that these odds are not very far away from the risk. This is a mathematical thing. Whenever p is small, this is true that the odds are very close to the risk. So the odds ratio is somewhere around 1.34. And when I use PROC-FREC, I get the RR and the OR, I get them together. They always go together, so that's why we specify relative risk and we get the relative risks, but we also get the odds ratio. So I specified I use an ODS select statement to only get the table I'm interested in, and here I see that the odds ratio is 0.7551 and the relative risk is 0.7643. So again, I have to trick SAS into getting me the estimate I want. I have to use this reverse scoring. When I use the reverse scoring, I get the odds and I get the relative risk. So the odds are somewhere around 1.32 and the odds ratio is somewhere around 1.32 and the relative risk is somewhere around 1.31. You can see from the confidence intervals that they are statistically significant because 1 is not in the confidence interval. You can also see that the p-value is close to 5% because this is close to containing 1. Of course, instead of coding a new variable, tricking SAS, we can also use formats. I will leave the code here and not talk about it. You can go to the homepage and look at the code if you want to try it out yourself. You specify the format that 1 means yes and 2 means no, then you calculate it, and now it's switched around. So this is a generalization of the t-test. The t-test looks at two groups, compares the mean of a variable. This generalizes this to the situation where we look at two groups and compare risks. What about ANOVA? What if we have more than two groups? Well, what if we have five groups? If I have five groups, and I do here because the ethnic variable is has five levels, then the null hypothesis that the risk of dying is in the same group, I can look at the table and I can calculate a chi-square statistic in exactly the same way. I get a chi-square value here. And actually, PROC-FREC can also provide graphical output using the plots option. So I will just illustrate this here. I use the table statement and here I specify plots and then I specify frequency plot, group vertical and so on, and this gives me this illustration of the table. What's the percentage in each of the five groups for the vaccinated children? What's the percentage in each of the five groups for the unvaccinated children?